lost everything in Hurricane Charlie in 2004, so we're kind of used to seeing the hurricane slash typhoon damage. The only thing I really saw was there was a Christian graveyard that we drove by on a tour we took that had a few trees over. We noticed the cleanup efforts, maybe a little bit of what potholes on one of the roads and the sidewalks, but I mean, it was amazing that for what hit here, there was like nothing. We were worried about whether we were even going to be able to have the conference.
Yeah, to be honest, I was surprised. I really thought that there was going to be more damage than there was.
We all saw from the TV and clips and the news before, a few weeks ago, how bad it was and, you know, how severely the destination was impacted. So I was very surprised to see how much it's been cleaned up, and I know there's a lot of efforts from the community, from business people, as well as citizens of Macau to help, you know, put things back in order. And I've noticed a few areas, of course, trees being affected and certain buildings and etc. But it's barely noticeable. In destinations like this one, where there's a very large income coming from the tourism, it's heavily dependent on it. It's very important for the destination to recover as quickly as possible.
你可以見到其實之前停咗團客之後，而家再復復翻咧，無論人數同埋你見到呢個流量都係回復翻之前嘅水平咁樣。咁但係如果一啲民住嘅居或者一啲非旅遊景點的話咧，我覺得嘅情況未係真係咁樂觀嘅。呢度就係旅遊街啦。咁你見到一啲咁先都會有啲平嘅衣物擺翻曬喺度啊，就係因為受災嘅時候可能浸咗，咁佢哋都唔想話血本無歸，咁都要 平啲咁放翻出嚟咯，即係例如呢啲啦。咁再前面有一度咧，都成日度話其實水災，咁佢哋就要結業就要大平賣咁咯。如果你話旅遊區嘅回復咧，絕對係超乎於大家嘅預期中嘅理想嘅。咁但係去翻民居嘅情況一睇咧，其實並唔係真係咁完美嘅，因為以我自己住嘅區為例啦，我樓下嘅一啲超級市場咧，仍然係好似戰後嘅重災區咁樣嘅，未復到業啦。之前佢一啲 補貼啊，各樣嘅嘢，呢啲要繼續啦。咁然後再諗嘅就係一啲喺颱風裡面俾我哋見到一啲基建上措施嘅不足嘅程度，例如一啲水啊、電啊、網絡咁呢啲，其實係咪都要俾一個信心俾澳門人，就係會見到下次再同樣咁強勁嘅災難性嘅事件發生嘅時候，都唔會受影響。呢啲我覺得都要做嘅。
I think, you know, hopefully it's a lesson learned for the authorities here in Macau and also from the mainland who provide the source of electricity and power for the island here to maybe be more prepared for the future in terms of having backup powers necessarily for these particular situations.